Came through with a bad bitch and tight britches. Made the whole book on flight, I'm tight vicious. Black boy flies, stupid racks, oysters on my plate. So much bread, I think I got white privilege.
Yo, what's good? It's your boy Swole the Poet, man. And we back with another episode, episode 9 on Black Prosperity. Got my boy Ghost in here, no power.
What up?
The creator, Travel Drippin' here, man. Appreciate you coming on the show, brother, man. You know what I'm saying? Oh, man. I know we've been going for a little while, but I had to break it in. You know, here I just wanted to feature my boy because he really out here exemplifying black boy joy. You know what I'm saying? Out here traveling, creating content, a little bit of that. And just wanted to bring you on here so you could give people a little bit of knowledge about that lifestyle and the things that, you know, what it's been able to create for you as far as your platform and Travel Drip and stuff like that.
And that's the blessings, man. The job is definitely the reason why I do any of the Travel Drip. So shout out to that.
Is there like a, what inspired Travel Drip?
Well, I've been traveling for about 4 years now. And the thing is, like, I always wanted to do something while I was traveling. Mm-hmm. So it was like, yo, I can't be in front of the camera because I have nobody to record it for me.
Yeah.
And I don't like being on camera talking. So I was like, yo, I got to figure out something because it's like so much opportunity out here. And I meet so many celebrities on the road traveling. So it's like, yo, I think it was when I met Waka Flocka.
Yeah.
That's when it was like, this is what I can do. Mm-hmm. I can start asking people what they're wearing. That's their travel drip.
Yeah.
I got the idea. And then ever since then, the ball's been rolling.
Yeah. So from like when I met you, you know, I've always got the vibe as you're a guy who knows a guy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're that person. So like, how did that come about? Like, was you like a, you know, all-star high school football player?
Then you just, was a class clown.
You know, you just did it. You just like, you chose to go a different route. Like,
yeah, I was a class clown. I mean, it's just like, just having the gift to meet people and connect. And like, when I do the travel drip, it's like, I walk up to people, not even knowing them, and then I ask them to do a video, and they'd be like, yeah, sure. So I just make people feel comfortable. And then it's that platform that gives me the, you know, avenue to actually stop people and get the content. So
like, what advice would you give out to someone who's like, you know, maybe feel like they have some of the same characteristics, but they're struggling a little bit to get out of their shell, but they know they have the abilities, they know a lot of people, but, you know, when it comes to actually putting things in fruition, like, what's some insight or tips that you took to get where you are now?
Life is short. Like, if you don't do it now, then you'll never get it done. And then I think is when I met, I hate name dropping. What is his name? I can't even think of his name right now. But I met him in Chicago. Mm-hmm. And it was like maybe my third video. And I was like, bro, do you mind doing this travel trip? I didn't know who he was. He was actually like 300K following on Instagram and everything. And I didn't know who he was. I asked him to do a travel trip. He was like, yeah, we'll do it. And he gave me the confidence. He's like, yo, I can really do this. Like, I have something here. Mm-hmm. And my thing is just like, yo, life is short. Go ahead and do it. Like, don't wait for nobody.
Yeah. It's funny because I remember like you were first starting to talk about it. You were like, yo, I think I'm about to do this thing called travel trip, da, da, da. And like, I remember you starting and like to see like, mind you guys, this is like really fresh, honestly, probably with 3 months, two?
It's like 2 months.
But like the traction and like the notable people that have already been on the platform, like it's like crazy.
It's,
so,
yeah, it is crazy.
Like I'm honestly giving y'all like, let's call it an appetizer, sample, or terms, you know what I'm saying? Right. Like, because it's really about to go crazy. It's already turned up right now. Like, but I just think it's a unique concept, you know what I'm saying? Like, in my opinion, it kind of goes along like, you know, you just bring a positivity to the world, and that's just more stuff that we need. And, you know, you're also showing style and grace, especially with all the unique people that come from our community and stuff like that. Like, I love seeing a different type of styles and stuff like that, being that I'm into fashion, too. So sometimes I might see something like, oh, I got that show. Oh,
yeah.
What's those called? Get on Google real quick.
Exactly, like, exactly. But, you know, the crazy thing is, it's like, Travel Drip is... What I really want people to understand is Travel Drip is not just Balenciaga, Louis Vuitton, you know, high-end brands, everybody has their own definition of travel trip.
Yeah.
So, like, black, white, Indian, Mexican, everybody has their own definition, and you can't say this is not drip, because in their mind, it's drip to them. You know what I mean? So that's what I try to get across. Like, everybody's style is different, and I try to grasp everybody's style to be unique. You know what I mean? So, like, even if they're wearing sweatpants, but it's the way they're wearing sweatpants, what colors they got on. Exactly. Like, you know, somebody can't pull that off. Everybody can't pull off your fit. You know what I'm saying?
But that's because everybody not me. But exactly. I get what you're saying.
It's like getting the average people, you know, and I get some people say, like, why are you getting up? They got leggings on. They got sweatpants on. Well, they're different. You know, you can't tell me that's not drip, because in the white community, Golden Goose, they love that. You know, but black people look at that like, yo, your
and
shoes
dirty
are
as Air Forces.
Yeah, exactly. Right. They love that. But
I give a white girl $100, I see some Clear Forces on it.
Exactly. Right. First Clear Force, $100 off top. But no, it's just like, I just want, my thing is just catching everybody's style and then also promoting people.
Yeah.
Because I know a lot of people, and I know people that know people. So it's like always good to know somebody that you can put somebody else on to. So it's all about networking at the end of the day. Catching style and networking.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Like, we built our bond through, you know, my family, which was your family, like, through High Def and stuff like that. And
shout out to Amber Hurley.
Yeah.
She definitely helped me get Travel Drift started.
Like, yo, I love ideas. Amber. That's my dog. She know that.
Right.
She know that. She's solid for sure. Y'all definitely check out High Def and them, man.
Definitely check them out.
But, you know, with this Travel Drip, that incites that you travel a lot. So, with that, like, would you consider yourself essentially, like, do you have, like, a home you reside in, or do you live your life on the road?
I live life on the road.
Can you talk to me about that a little bit? Like, because to me, that sounds crazy. Like, that's lit. Like, you it feel me? Lit. Like, but do you ever feel like, all right, I do kind of just, like, I want to, like, just, I want to go somewhere and just chill. I want some familiarity. I don't want to just keep doing new shit.
Right. But, I mean, or not, I'm a different breed.
Yeah.
Like, I love traveling. Like, this is my life. This is what I do for a living. Like, I do it faithfully. Mm-hmm. And I'll take off here and there, visit family, friends. But, like, working, I really don't do none of work. So, why take off, spend money on an apartment, spend money on a car, all these extra bills, when I can just stack my money, generational wealth. You know what I'm saying? I have bigger goals than just, you know, catching content. Like, there's a reason why I catch the content. Because I'm trying to build something. And at the end of the day, I want to take care of my family, friends, you know, put people on. So it's all about connecting. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, it's all about networks. It's not what you know, it's who you know.
Mm.
I meet so many people on this travel trip.
Yeah.
And, like...
Like, outside of the videos?
Outside of the videos, yeah. I meet some cool people. Like, I would never know who they were until I stop them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And if I didn't do this traveling job, then I never would be where I'm at right now. You know what I'm saying? So the traveling, I love it. I really love being on the road. Like, people think I'm crazy for it, but it's, you know, it's, I go home when I want to. If I want to see family, I can do that. But it's just, I do nothing.
I mean, to be honest though, the way I view it is, you know, you do get one life, and there's so much of the world to see.
Exactly.
You know, we stay such in a minute box. You know, we don't expand our knowledge on things. So I definitely like, you know, I respect it a lot, you know.
Yeah, and
I
appreciate you.
Something I got to get my travel game up a little bit more, you know what I'm saying? But I'd be so hell-bit, like, you know, like, I got this going on. I got that going on. Like, for me, trips are more so planned instead of just...
Yeah.
You know, like, a little bit, I was a little bit younger and I have all the responsibilities. Like, right. I used to just... All right, fuck it, yeah, we out.
Exactly.
Like, let's just, you know what I'm saying? But I'm definitely finna get back to that for sure.
But the crazy thing is like, before I started traveling, I'd never been nowhere outside of Virginia. Like, maybe D.C., a couple family cruises.
Yeah.
But other than that, when I got this job, my world opened up.
Mm.
And it was like, why would I waste money on an apartment when I can just live on the road and live life how I really want to? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm still taking care of business. Don't get that twisted. Like, everything is taken care of that's supposed to be taken care of. Yeah. But I'm really living my dream and, you know, living life. So.
Yeah. And would you honestly say, like, you know, as we were talking when the cameras weren't on, you know what I'm saying? You were basically like, yeah, just liquidating. So do you think, like, with that, do you substantially save a lot more than you think the average person does?
What? Way more. Wait, at home, I don't pay no rent. I don't pay no electricity bills. Like, all that money is going to the bank. So I'm saving for a better thing. You know what I'm saying? And even my parents told me, like, yo, do what you're doing. Like, that's the best job anybody can get. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, why would you waste money on, you know, materialistic things when you can live life? You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm paying rent and all that, but what do I have show for it? Mm-hmm. I'm living life. Like, I'll have making memories. You know what I'm saying?
You have a lot of memories to make.
And then when I'm ready to settle down, I can do it. Yeah. So there's no rush on it. I'm spending money for a place when I'm at the work to maintain it. You know, I do take off. I have no money to spend because everything's on all the, you know, other stuff I have. So
yeah. So like, what is your ultimate end goal in this? And you know, is this something you see yourself doing for like the foreseeable future, or do you like, or is it like, because at a point, like once travel reaches a certain level, I don't really see how you can stop, because like it's built on
exactly
traveling.
It's going faster than what I expected. And you know, shout out to everybody that had my back in the beginning of the idea stages and giving me advice. There's been a lot of people that tapped in with me, helped me out. But it's like, I really want to get to the top, and I really want to do Travel Drip full time. Because I mean, it's not it's not really that much I do, but I enjoy it. You know, I love it. I love meeting new people. I love getting different stories. And, you know what I mean? It's just, bro, it's a whole different experience.
So, like, can we expect to see, like, any international travel videos coming up?
If I stop being lazy and not, I need to go outside the country. But, yeah, I definitely
want to. Yeah, I'm trying to see what they doing in the UK, the France.
I'm more of an island guy. So, anything, I would love to go to islands instead. The Caribbean. And I definitely would get the travel trip on islands. Yeah, that would be crazy. Yeah, that would be like an OnlyFans travel trip. Some crazy stuff like that.
You got to subscribe.
VIP access.
But like I was saying, you know what I'm saying? And that's what this platform is for. And, you know, y'all definitely need to go and follow Travel Drip. Did you create a YouTube and all this stuff yet?
Bro, it's... I got TikTok and Instagram. My Instagram is much better than my, you know, TikTok. Mm-hmm. But I post everything I do on Instagram on TikTok. I started the YouTube, but it's like... I get like 1 or 2 views on YouTube.
Yeah,
but I mean, I'm gonna
start posting YouTube more, just takes consistency, man. Yeah. Shout out to my business partner, my brother Juice, man. Like, on some real shit. Like, I just came to him the other day. Like, I was talking to him, you know, my people that support me, and I took a little month hiatus from Black Prosperity because I just had to, you know, align my chakras and get my energy back together. You know what I'm saying? And you know, the reason that this is even where it's at today is because of my boy. You know, those constant conversations of just, you know, hey, stick with it.
And that's what
stay consistent. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's gonna come. Like, you know what I'm saying? Take the time that you need to, you know, get your mind right so you can be your best you moving forward. But you know what I'm saying? Just stay consistent, and the results will show.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We have a semi-viral post going on TikTok right now from the Vision Network platform and what he does with his special interviews.
Which is fire. Y'all need to check that. If y'all don't check that out.
You know, bro, it's crazy with it.
It is definitely fire.
But yeah, man, just stay with it. Just in general, though, you know what I'm saying? And this is more so unique because it's like, I typically already have people that would you say, quote unquote, established. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But it's like, bro, the brand speaks for itself. You know what I'm saying? You've already had Sway Lee on there.
Right.
You had, what was it, Shorty from, was it Love & Hip Hop? Or was it, what reality TV show? Bad Girls Club?
I don't
Where's she from? She's from TV.
Which one?
It's a recent one. I think you just did it, right?
I had one from Netflix.
Netflix.
Yeah, Cooking Show.
Sorry, yeah. I be watching Betty's West. So.
Bro, it was crazy. Let me tell you that, bro. It is crazy how I meet these people. I just like the outfit, and I'll stop them. And not knowing nothing about who they are or what they have going on.
Nigga, you knew who Sway Lee was. Shut the fuck up.
Okay, I knew
who
Sway Lee was. Yeah, I knew who it was. I was like, yo.
All right. I was saying, like, come on. That girl was a real crazy.
Cancel that. We'll talk about Sway Lee. So I seen him. It was in Salt Lake City, Utah. Right?
Yeah.
I'm walking, and I see, like, these group of, there was Mexican guys. and they was all huddled around and it was taking pictures, and all you seen was this purple jacket, but it was white, just in case y'all don't know that brand. But okay, he had the jacket on, and I'm like, that has to be somebody. There's a reason why, because they're like snapping pictures. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna keep on walking. He turns around, and then I just played off a little bit. Oh, Swaley, what's up, bro? And then I slowed down and came up next to me. I'm like, yo, bro, do you mind if I get a video? Like, I do fashion. I have it on my shirt, you know what I mean? He was like, yeah, no problem, let's do it. I was like, whoa, easy. Like, easy. Just walk up to anybody, and people are willing to do the video. Because I don't do nothing crazy. I just ask them what they're wearing and then try to promote them.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where I think people love it, because it gives them a chance to shine. And I don't mind it, you know what I mean? I'm here for the people. That's why I think it's so going so well. Because there's always somebody that you can use that you didn't know. You know what I'm saying? This works out.
And I will say too, you know, when we went to that collab studio, that was that. Crazy. I feel like that's you, like you really went crazy.
I'm actually meeting up with somebody tomorrow,
yesterday. Like you really went crazy with that. You know, I think that was a great opportunity for everybody. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
It definitely helped out a lot.
All in all, like, is there anything, like, any closing remarks or, like, anything that you want to, like, give to the people about, like, maybe, like, info on how to get the right equipment to, you know, that since you travel, I don't want right. to, I know you don't travel with fucking 12 cameras and, and you know, and it's just like, you know, like, you, so you keep it fairly simple, but the yeah, quality so. Is very, very crisp and clear. Appreciate so, you. Like, with Amazon, that, you know, Amazon?
Amazon, y'all got the whole setup off of Amazon. And, like, I'm all about quality. Like, I want the videos to come out. Like, if you see my stuff in the beginning, you'll see, like, how I progressed and made everything better and stuff like that. It just takes time. And you got to want your stuff to be good. I want everybody to enjoy my videos and want to come back for more. So that's what gives me the ambition to make sure my stuff is quality every time I put it out. You know what I mean? And it's like, bro, it's so many people support it. So many people. Like, the shirt I got on. The dude in Houston. I didn't even know him. I got off of work. I was in a food spot.
And I was looking at his shirt. Yeah, I'm like, that's been hard. Like,
he was in LaPearl out of Houston. Yeah. My boy, Looch. But, like, I met him, and he was, you know, I do security, private security, stuff like that.
Yeah.
And it was hollering at him. We was just chappling up. And he was like, I have a clothing line. And I was like, well, I do travel drill. Just when you can do a video. Bro, I don't know him from Adam and Eve, but the dude was the coolest dude I met, bro. He invited me to his house. I don't even know you, bro. I could have, you know, could have been lit, you know, some crazy stuff. But, yo, it's just the, you know, the camaraderie of meeting new people, and people are generally nice, you know what I'm saying? And I met him, and every time I go to Houston, I hit him up. Let me get some clothes, bro. Always supporting, you know what I mean?
I know you mentioned private security. Before we go, do you have any funny stories about any time you've done a private event or anything like that? Like,
bro, it's so much, man.
And would you say, what? Like, in
I
that...
I got a story for you. I was in Atlanta. Pushing that travel drip, I was in the club, and I was in the lounge inside Atlanta, and I seen a celebrity. I ain't gonna tell you who it was. It was a celebrity. Everybody knows who he is. And I was like, yo, bro, do you mind if I get a travel drip video with you? I have the travel drip shirt on. Like, you see, I wasn't on no, like, fan stuff. It was like, yo, I wanted to get this content. And he was like, nah, bro, I'm good. Yo, it hurt my soul. Like, it really put me, set me back. You know, because I really want to be like, yo, bro, you met me before. I've done security for you before. Don't be like that. But you know what? I was like, I let it go.
Remember me from school? Hell, you can know what I look like.
You know what? Bro, but it's, you know what? It was like, you know
but
what?
It's going to be those moments, though.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? It's going to, trust me, there's plenty of, at this point, when I reach out to people that I know I have no access to,
right.
It's okay. Like, right. I don't care. You might not know me now, but I know you'll remember me. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? And it's about staying consistent and stuff like that.
I just be like, it is what it is. You know, so many people turn me down because people think this stuff is staged. This is like actual legit. Like, I walk up to people in the airport randomly and be like, hey, I do content. Like, do you mind doing a video on your outfit? People will say yes. People say no. They look at you like you're crazy. I'm like, okay, thank you. You know, so I mean, you get all kind of people, but it's all about knowing what you have and the support that you have in the background. That keeps you going. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I get discouraged about, you know, not getting the content I want to get. But, you know, it is what it is. It'll come with time. Like you said, everything happens for a reason.
So would you trade what you do now to just be like full-time private security? Because, you know, I got a buddy in Big Flex, you know, he basically Fredo main man, and looks like he's living his life.
It's 50-50.
50-50.
Because I really enjoy what I really don't work hard at all. But yeah. I really love my job. And I love the avenue it gave me to, you know. Because everything, like I said, everything happens for a reason. You know, I would love to do private security. Like, I'm 6'5", I'm 260. Like, mm-hmm. I work out, you know. Yeah. I would love to do it. But, like, travel trip is my passion.
Yeah.
I love my job, so, you know.
Hey, excuse me. I will say for all my ATL artists out here, man. Especially those that are, you know, on that upward trajectory, man. Definitely check my boy out. He's qualified. He's certified and all that important shit that you need. If there's anything, you know, for the most part, man, fuck that. We in Atlanta. I don't even know what's going on. That nigga shit good. You feel me? A-Twin. It's like, no.
Exactly.
Well, some real shit, man. This is my boy Travel Drip, man. I appreciate you coming on, man. Leave the people with a quotable. Or a nice little IG caption. They can leave, you know, some inspirational.
My favorite one is, you know, life is short. Make every alpha count. Just keep it simple, bro.
Life is short. Make every alpha count.
Yeah.
That's why I be really putting short. That shit on and sit in the living room. You niggas won't understand. Where you going? To the crib. I don't know.
You gotta look fly anywhere.
About this shit.
You know, my mindset, real quick before we leave, my mindset is you never know who you meet. And you know, the crazy thing is when I'm like rushing to get out and I just put anything on, that's when I meet the people that, you know, is somebody. I'm like, damn. Mm-hmm. I wish I would have put someone fresher.
You might meet your wife at the Exxon,
exactly.
Nigga.
Exactly.
You know, so she wanted to talk to you, though. You came out of your fucking busted ass. I don't know. Whatever the fuck you got on, you know what I'm saying? Go ahead and throw on your purple.
Exactly.
Whatever you niggas wear.
I try to fly every day I come out of the house.
You know, I ain't into the hottest fashion shit. I just wear whatever I like, you know.
Exactly.
It's your boy Swarta Poet, man. It's Ghost Travel Drip, man. It's episode 9. And we out.
Appreciate you.